We express our gratitude to all journalists and extend our best wishes for everyone.
Aspataki mengucapkan terima kasih kepada pemerintah Hong Kong, terima kasih kepada Kementerian Tenaga Kerja Hong Kong, terima kasih kepada para pemberi kerja karena telah mempekerjakan para pekerja migran Indonesia sejak tahun 1980-an.
Aspataki extend its heartfelt appreciation to Hong Kong government, the Hong Kong Labor Department, and employers for employing Indonesian migrant workers since the 1980s.
Hong Kong menjadi negara favorit pekerja migran dari Indonesia setelah Taiwan, Malaysia, dan Saudi.
After Taiwan, Hong Kong has become one of Indonesia's domestic migrant workers' favorite destination country, followed by Malaysia and Saudi Arabia.
Perekonomian para pekerja migran Indonesia dan keluarganya semakin hari semakin meningkat dan semakin sejahtera.
The economic well-being of Indonesia domestic migrant workers and their families has been increasing and flourishing over the years.
Pemberi kerja Hong Kong telah turut membantu dan meningkatkan kesejahteraan pekerja migran Indonesia.
Hong Kong employers have played a significant role in contributing to the prosperity of Indonesian migrant workers and their families.
Kami sekali lagi pemerintah Hong Kong karena telah memberikan perlindungan kepada pekerja migran Indonesia sangat-sangat baik sekali.
Once again, we thanks the Hong Kong government for the excellent protection of Indonesian migrant workers.
Pada kesempatan yang baik ini, Aspataki yang telah ikut menandatangani fakta integritas pemberlakuan peraturan kepala badan nomor 09 tahun 2020 yaitu pembebasan biaya penempatan. Hari ini hadir di Hong Kong ingin menyampaikan kepada publik, kepada masyarakat luas bahwa peraturan kepala badan yaitu peraturan kepala BP2MI nomor 09 tahun 2020 dan keputusan kepala BP2MI nomor 260 tahun 2022.
In this favorable occasions, Aspataki which have signed the integrity pact perban number 9 years 2020 concerning the placement fee exemption. Aspataki is present in Hong Kong to address to the public regarding to the Indonesia government regulations, namely the head of BP2MI regulations number 9 years 2020 and the head of BP2MI decree number 260 years 2022.
Dalam dua peraturan tersebut, pada prinsipnya adalah peningkatan perlindungan kepada pekerja migran Indonesia, yaitu ingin mengurangi beban biaya pada pekerja migran Indonesia, yaitu semua biaya penempatan menjadi beban pemberi kerja dan termasuk jasa perusahaan Indonesia satu bulan gaji yang dulunya ditanggung pekerja migran Indonesia menjadi ditanggung oleh pemberi kerja.
In these two regulations, the main principle is to enhance the protection of Indonesian migrant workers and reduce their financial burdens. All placement costs are now should be borne by employers, including the service or fee of Indonesian Employment Agency, equivalent to 1 month's salary, which other placement costs used to be borne by the Indonesian migrant workers themselves, but is now, according to the regulations, now covered by the employers.
Adapun maksudnya, sejak peraturan Indonesia di atas diundangkan, seluruh pekerja migran Indonesia harusnya tidak boleh lagi membayar biaya penempatan, biaya pelatihan.
Therefore, according to this Indonesia regulations, Indonesia domestic migrant workers from Indonesia should no longer have to pay replacement costs except for training costs.
Sementara selama ini, para pemberi kerja masih menggunakan pedoman pada standard employment contract.
However, until now, employers still have been using the standard employment contract as their guideline.
perbedaan komponen biaya penempatan yang menjadi beban pemberi kerja sebagaimana tersebut pada standar employment contract dengan dua peraturan di atas cukup membuat anggota Aspataki dalam memfasilitasi pemenuhan dokumen persyaratan sebelum PMI bekerja ke Hong Kong mengalami kendala-kendala pembiayaan selain biaya penempatan yang disebutkan dalam standard employment contract.
The different in placement cost components that now become the employer's responsibility as mentioned in the standard employment contract compared to the two regulations mentioned above has caused challenges for Aspataki members in facilitating the fulfillment of document requirement for Indonesian migrant worker can work in Hong Kong, particularly regarding financing issues other than the placement cost stated in the standard employment contract.
Aspataki berharap kepada pemerintah Hong Kong dan para pemberi kerja serta asosiasi majikan ikut mendukung melaksanakan pembebasan biaya penempatan bagi PMI kecuali biaya pelatihan yang menjadi tanggung jawab PMI dan pemerintah daerah asal PMI berasal.
Aspataki hopes that the Hong Kong government's employers and employers association will support the implementation of placement fee exemption for Indonesian domestic migrant workers except for training costs, which remain the responsibility of migrant workers and their respective local governments.
Demikian kurang dan lebihnya kami mohon maaf. Salam masyarakat Hong Kong yang kami cintai.
We apologize for any shortcomings in our communications and extend Aspataki greetings to the entire Hong Kong community.
Demikian mungkin yang kami sampaikan terkait dengan press release hari ini. Mungkin ada beberapa yang rekan-rekan wartawan mau menanyakan kepada kami. Dipersilakan.
If any questions from journalist friends, please welcome. Maybe because of the time, we can give for three questions maybe. Thank you.
Sebenarnya kalau perbedaan peraturan badan nomor 9 tahun 2020 dan peraturan kepala badan nomor 260 tahun 2021 lebih menonjol kepada jasa P3MI-nya, jasa perusahaan yang ada di Indonesia menjadi tanggung jawab pemberi kerja.
Okay. The difference is mainly is about the Indonesia agency placement fee. As you know, that is not stated clearly in the implementations.
You mean only the placement fee, right?
For example.
And what is the other's fee?
Paspor yang diperhatikan.
Jadi paspor dulu dibebankan kepada majikan 360.000, sekarang menjadi nol, zero cost untuk paspor.
And there's some revision also in the passport cost. Before, passport cost was borne by employers, and now passport cost is become zero. It's borne by our government.
Do you afraid that this new policy will make Hong Kong employer will consider to employ workers from other places, and do not call, they may not workers from your country?
Kami yakin bahwa pekerja migran Indonesia memiliki kompetensi yang benar-benar sudah memenuhi persyaratan yang diminta oleh pemberi kerja di Hong Kong.
We believe that our Indonesian migrant workers have qualifications and skill that can complete the employer's requirements.
Jadi apabila ada kasus satu bulan bekerja kemudian pekerja migrannya bermasalah, kita mengikuti aturan yang berlaku di Hong Kong.
If the condition exists, we follow the Hong Kong level regulations to settle these cases.
Dalam peraturan pemerintah Indonesia majikan diwajibkan memberikan itu sesuai dengan keputusan Kepala Badan nomor 260 tahun 2022. Nanti kita akan dikasihkan satu peraturan tersebut.
Yeah, there is regulations of our from our National Board of the Labor Protections in the site have written how much should be paid by employer.
So I'm here. So hi here over here.
Maybe
do you have the exact amount of how much our Hong Kong employers really need to pay for it?
Maybe this just a sample on this, something like estimate. If there is excess, maybe we assume that something like maybe around 4,000 or 5,000 to make adjustment, something like that.
So is it the
We don't know how much Hong Kong employer have paid existing now, but we assume that if we really want to run these regulations, maybe we must discuss further, and we estimate around that amount.
So, cost to Hong Kong, what causes you to promote this?
Apa alasan kita mempromosikan apa program direktif
di sini peraturan pemerintah Indonesia memang mewajibkan kepada kita semua agar biaya penempatan ditanggung oleh pemberi kerja.
Yeah, as we know that our the regulation of
Indonesia
BP2MI number 9/2020. It is addressed that all the placement costs should be borne by employers.
Peraturan Kepala Badan nomor 9 tahun 2022 diundangkan pada Agustus 2020 dan saya ulang, Peraturan Badan nomor 9 tahun 2020 diundangkan pada 18 Agustus tahun 2020, kemudian diberlakukan 2 tahun setelah diundangkan, tepatnya dengan menggunakan keputusan Kepala Badan nomor 260 tahun 2022.
Actually, this regulation already registered and published at Indonesia on March 2020. And then it's been revised to a decree number 260 in years of 2022.
Untuk negara Malaysia, Timur Tengah, Saudi, Uni Emirat, semua ditanggung oleh pemberi kerja.
Termasuk pelatihannya.
For example, for the implementation of the law, for the domestic workers going to the Middle East, such as Saudi Arabia, Qatar, United Arab Emirates, Kuwait, and Malaysia, all the placement costs and the training costs was borne by employer.
Tapi untuk Hong Kong ada kemungkinan itu.
Kecuali Hong Kong. Hong Kong pelatihannya tetap ditanggung oleh pekerja migran Indonesia dan pemerintah daerah.
Karena sudah perlindungannya lebih baik.
Karena Hong Kong perlindungan kepada pekerja asing, khususnya pekerja dari Indonesia, sudah sangat bagus.
Ya. Yeah. Unlike the Middle East and the Malaysia domestic workers, for Hong Kong employers, our government is exclude the training costs, and our government allow our domestic worker to bond for the training cost by themselves, so not borne by employers, because the protection of migrant workers in Hong Kong is already better than other countries in Middle East.
Mungkin sudah cukup. Seharusnya peraturan ini berjalan paling lambat Februari 2022. Namun Aspataki melihat pada saat kita sama-sama melaksanakan peraturan ini, ada yang masih menafsirkan seakan-akan majikan masih menganggap bahwa biaya penempatan sebagian masih ditanggung oleh PMI. Padahal sejak Agustus 2020 peraturan badan diterbitkan, seluruh komponen biaya penempatan ditanggung oleh pemberi kerja.
Actually, this regulation already effective must be implementation 6 months after the regulation was issued or registered to the our ministers of flow and justice. But in the implementation, they still have a big issue or misunderstanding about the. We consult there is a misunderstanding. The other side, employment, some employments follows the standard employment contract, which means that employees only have obligation to bond the cost listed in the standard employment contract, something like that.
Six months to pay no extra fee, or after 6 months, the workers come here and then they have to, you know, sorry, employer have to start paying for the fee. That's the first question. Let's go with that first.
Actually, now it's years of 2023 already, and BP2ME decree number 260 already been established on February 2022. So already more than 6 months actually. Actually, it has been socialized between two government also to discuss about this regulation. But now we just want to address that Indonesia have these regulations about the extension of the placement cost.
So meaning that no employers right now in Hong Kong are actually fee or they are already paying for it?
That's why we want to come to Hong Kong here to address this regulation. We hope that all the employers shall be cooperate together for the protection of the migrant workers. And we hope that this regulation can be implemented.
So meaning that no employers right now in Hong Kong are in line with the implementation because they are still using the old employment agreement. Am I correct?
Maybe we can say that some, but some of them already implemented, especially for the workers that have experience and good in their Cantonese, good in their Mandarin, in their language, and they can have experience in working in Hong Kong before. Already implemented some of them.
Okay. So, okay, and sorry, just another question I want to ask for your stand, because there are cases reported that migrant workers got overcharged by the agencies, and right now, if this implementation comes into Hong Kong, then probably that problem is solved automatically. But so what's your stance on this new implementation? You support that, or you think like this would cause burden to Hong Kong families and that's unfavorable to workers coming from your second is what the communication has done between your association and the Indonesian national agency when discussing about this implementation. Thank you.
Untuk implementasi ini, bagaimana apakah kita apa? Please speak once again.
Sorry, I didn't catch the last. Already, we have already discussed with our Indonesian national agency. We call that BP2ME. Indonesia, we call that BP2ME.
Is that a
language? It stands for National Board for Protection of Indonesia Migrant Worker.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe.
Satu lagi? Satu lagi. Kalau ada yang keberatan, mungkin tidak harus mengambil pekerja migran dari Indonesia.
Okay, because this is regulations, maybe we cannot force the employers. Maybe employers can consider to hired made from something like that can suitable for the employer, something like that. Thank you very much.
Okay, terima kasih. Kurang lebihnya kami mohon maaf. Sampai ketemu dengan kesempatan-kesempatan yang akan datang. Terima kasih.
Thank you very much.